Hey everybody, my name is Stanley, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how to use Meow, which is a little app that I wrote that lets your cat software communicate with Upwordly, which is a live transcription CMS that I designed and created myself. So let's get started. First, you're going to receive a zip file like this, so you're going to open that up, and I'm going to just drag that to my desktop and let it extract. Sorry, my monitor is like over here and my computer's over here, so that's why you get to see this out of my head. Okay, so that's done. Now, where is it? Here it is. Now I'm gonna open that folder up and run the setup installer. Let that finish. Take a sip. Tea. Okay, after it's installed, it should run automatically. You also get this icon here, which I still need to change. This is just like Electron's default icon, but whatever. Okay, so you're gonna close this, get started. So first thing you're gonna do is you need to install the drivers for the COM ports. So click on that and it'll just show like a black screen really briefly on your screen, but it means that everything went well. And then the second step is kind of important because this is going to open your COM port manager. And so what this is it's showing you the COM ports that are used on your computer, and I pretty much have everything available except for 4, which I believe is what my Steno machine is running on. And so you can think of COM ports as kind of like pipelines or chutes. Like you throw something into the, you know, at the mouth of it, and then at the other end somebody receives something, right? So we're gonna set up a COM port pair. I typically like 5, and as convention I just use the COM port number that's one above it. So click on add pair, and so you should now see 2 COM ports appear under virtual COM ports that are kind of, they look like they're kind of connected together. So COM 5 is your receiving COM port, which means it's receiving the data. And then COM port 6 is kind of where it's like spitting it out. So keep this open for reference as you move through this. So click on move on. Now, based on what I just told you, the output COM port is 6, so that's what I'm putting here. And then I'm gonna connect to Upwordly via username and job. You can also connect by URL by just simply typing in the URL, but I'm gonna just do username and job. And so this is the job I wanna open. The username is found in your URL after the first slash. And then this is the job name, so Stanley and Coachella. So I'm gonna type those in to these boxes. Stanley, Coachella, okay? And then hit connect, and it says, OMG, I'm at Coachella. And so since the text matches, it means that it's connected. So this is like a two-way street. Like in the editor, in Upwordly, you know, if I type something into the box, it'll show up. But we're trying to get it to connect to your cat software, so let's do that. So now this is pretty much done, so set it aside, and in a later video I might show you guys how to do this in case Catalyst, but I'm using Eclipse right now. Sorry, something's in my eye. So in Eclipse you're gonna start translation normally. And then the thing you're gonna add is an output method. So I'm gonna just delete it and re-add it for demo's sake. So output modality, I guess, should be set to ANSI. And then we want to output to a COM port, and then set that up to be COM port 5, because remember, 5 is the input COM port. I don't know why it says it's like broken or something. I don't know. Who knows? Then hit OK. Okay. And then I should make sure my steno machine is connected now. Test. Okay, cool. Okay, so now I'm gonna start a job. So blah, 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 blah. And so the way that you know that it's connected is you can watch this window. The way that you know that it's connected is you can watch this window and you can see the text that's coming out. So that means it's connected. And also you can see that whatever I'm writing into Eclipse is coming up on Upwordly. Oh, not that. Oops. Ah, I can't steno. Upwordly, I clearly need to add that to my dictionary, but anyways, that's it. So now, pretty much you can go to this URL, or if you go to this URL, now you'll be able to see everything that I'm writing into Eclipse. Blah. All right, so that was it. If you guys have any questions, you can tweet at me at stanographer. All of my contact info is at stanographer.com. So you can contact me there and have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye.